Hello, my dear students. Hope you all are doing well at home. I am Anjana Jindal and I welcome you all in my English literature class of class 4. So, children, today I am back here with the revision of chapter 3. And the name of our chapter is Henry. Yes. So, children, as your UTs are ahead, so you would have prepared your UT syllabus, no? Yes, so I hope you all are prepared to do a revision worksheet. Yes, so here is a revision worksheet for you. Yes, children, so here is the revision worksheet. So, children, first you have to solve this revision worksheet with your own. Okay, first as a test, you have to do it as a test. Okay, it's a revision test for you, just for your practice. Okay, yes, and after solving this worksheet, then you can tell your answers which are given at the end. Okay, so let's start. See, children, question number one is write the meanings. So here in this question, you have to write down the meanings of the words which are given here. Okay, so let's see the words. First word is outstanding. First word is outstanding. So you have to write down the meaning of this word. Now the next word is rigid. Yes, rigid. So you have to write down the meaning of the word rigid. Now next word is crest. Children, what is a crest? If you remember the chapter, yes. So, you have to write down the meaning of crest. Next word is brandishing. Yes, brandishing. So, what does it mean? That you have to write over here. Okay. Then, the next word is smuggle. Yes, smuggle. You have to write down the meaning of the word smuggle. And now the last word is incident. Yes, incident. So what is the meaning of incident? That you have to write here. Okay. So these are the words whose meanings you have to write here in this question. Let's move to the next question. So, children, now question number 2. Write any 3 differences between house lizards and chameleons. So, children, in the chapter we have studied about chameleons, right? And how they differ from the house lizards, right? So, any of the 3 differences, there are many differences between these two, but we have to mention only 3 here according to this question. Okay. So, don't write all the differences which I have given you in the exercises of the chapter. Just mention any 3 differences between house lizards and chameleons. Okay. Now, question number 3. So, question number 3 is put a tick against the sentences that are true and a cross against those that are false. Yes, true or false, you can say. Yeah, so here you have to put a tick or a cross. So let's see the sentences. As sentence A, the chameleon is not a poisonous reptile. So just think, chameleon is a poisonous reptile or not, and then mark it, okay, as true or false, whatever you feel. Now sentence B, the gardener knew a lot about chameleons. So children, what do you think? Did the gardener know a lot about chameleons? Did he give the correct information? Just think and then mark your answer. Now, the sentence C. Miss Daniels rushed into the room on hearing the principal scream. So children, just think, did Miss Daniels rush into the room after hearing principal scream or some other reason? Just think and then put your answer as tick or cross. Okay. So children, let's see question number 4. So our question is, one animal is the odd one out in each of these groups. Circle the animal that does not fit in. So children, here 4 animals are given in each group and one is odd one. Okay, in each of them. So that you have to find out that which animal is odd here in this group. Okay. And then you have to circle that animal. Okay. And means you should know that why the particular animal which you are going to circle is odd one here in this group. Why it is odd. What is the reason you should know. Anna? I had already explained you during the explanation of chapter and exercises, no? Yes. So there are some features which differ the animals from each other, no? Yeah. So keep those things in mind and then circle the odd one out. Okay. So let's see. Group A. Wasp. Butterfly. Earthworm. B. So children, which one is odd here? That you have to circle. Okay. Now, group B. Ladybird, crow, pigeon, and parrot. So, among these 4, which one is odd? That you have to find out and you have to circle it. Okay. Let's see. Group C. Frog. Crocodile. Giraffe. And hippopotamus. So just find out the odd one here in this group. And circle that name of the animal. Okay. Now let's see group D. It is given as shark, octopus, dolphin, and goldfish. So out of these, which one is odd one, you have to find out and then circle that odd one. Okay. Yes. So now let's move to the next question. And our next question is question number 5. Okay. So let's see the question. Fill in the blanks with correct collective nouns. So here you have to fill the given blanks with the correct collective nouns. Okay. You have to write down the collective noun here. Group name basically. Okay. So, a dash of chameleons. Next one, a dash of oxen. Next one is a dash of penguins. Yes. And the last one is a dash of rats. So children, here you have to fill the collective nouns, means the group names of these animals. Okay children, So children, now let's move to question number 6. Yes, it's a reference to context. A context is given to you from the book, from the chapter, and based on this context, few questions are being asked, okay, which you have to answer, right? So let's read the extract first. Mrs. Ghosh screamed. Henry would probably have liked to blush a deep red, but he turned a bright green instead, as that was the color of the papayas. Mrs. Ghosh's assistant, Miss Daniels, rushed in, took one look at the chameleon and joined in the screaming. So children, just think for a while that what this extract says or defines. Okay, just think of the incident which happened in the story, right? Yeah, what Henry did basically, yes. So now based on these lines, here few questions are given which you have to answer. So let's see the questions. Question A. Why did Mrs. Ghosh scream? So children, why did Mrs. Ghosh scream? Just think and write down the answer. Okay. Just read these lines again. You will get your answer. Yes. Now, let's see question B. Why do you think Henry turned a bright green? So, children, why Henry turned a bright green? The answer is there, hidden in these lines, given lines above. Right? Yeah. So just find the answer and write. Okay. Now let's see question C. Which word in the given lines means someone whose duty is to help? So children, you have to find out the word which has the same meaning as someone whose duty is to help. One word for this group of words basically. Okay, yes. Now let's see question D. What did Henry do when Miss Daniels started screaming? So children, when Miss Daniels started screaming, what did Henry do that time? Yes, if you remember. Yeah. So just write down the answer. Okay. So children, now let's move to next question, that is question number 7. Yes. So our next question is, rewrite these sentences using not. So you have to use not and then you have to write these sentences again. Okay. Means you have to change the given sentences into negative sentences by using not. Isn't it? Yes. So let's see. First one. Mrs. Ghosh likes papayas. So you have to use not and then write the sentence again. Now, B part. People are afraid of chameleons. Then C part. My sister and I were working on our project. So in these given sentences, you have to make the negative ones. Okay. Yeah. By using not. Right. Yeah. Now let's move to next question. That is question number 8. What danger did grandfather save Henry from? So children, what was the danger from which grandfather saved Henry? just think about that danger and then write down what was that danger. Okay. Now next question, the last question, question number 9. When the children saw Henry, they ran in all directions. Why did they do this? What would you have done if you were in the classroom? So children, at this situation, if you were there in the classroom, just imagine, then what you would have done? Just think and then write. And also, okay. Just write the answers very carefully. Okay. So children, after completing this, then only you have to check your answers. So answers are given in the upcoming slides. Okay. But first you have to complete with your own. And then only you have to see the answers and check your answers with the answers given in this video. Okay. So now here is the answer sheet. Question 1, write their meanings. So here the meanings are also given along with the words. Okay. So you can tell your answers whether you have done correctly or not. And please check your spellings as well. Okay, children. Yes. Here, question number 2, the 3 differences between house lizards and chameleons. Here I have mentioned these 3. You can mention others as well, any of the 3. Okay. Yes. Then, true or false? You can just check. Okay. Now question number 4, I have circled the odd ones, right? Just check it out whether you have done correctly or not. And question 5, fill in the blanks with correct collective nouns. Next question, question 6, reference to context. All the answers are given here. You can tell your answers with the answers given here. Okay. Now the last slide, question 7. I have rewritten the given sentences using not. You just check it that whether you have used the not at the correct place or not. Okay, then question 8 and question 9 answers are given. Check it carefully. So now children, I hope you all have enjoyed this revision worksheet, right? And you have revised the chapter well. So now it's the time for your home assignment. And in your homework, you have to prepare your unit syllabus well. Okay? Okay then, stay safe, stay happy. Bye-bye. Take care.